Deer Park High School. It's Friday, May 3rd, 2024. Welcome back to the Deer Network. I'm Bella Smith.
And I'm Jace Dominguez. Today, how the transfer portal affects our student athletes, the latest in sports, and important end of the year dates. But first, your weekly news.
Our top story of the month, our one-act play company is heading to state. We showed the Ferrymen at San Jack Central for the region competition and were one of the two teams who advanced. Congratulations to Yamilet Castron for outstanding technician, Joshua Fisher for all-star cast, also Autumn Ramsey and Caitlin Ivins for honorable mention all-star cast. The state competition will be held May 18th at the Austin ISD PAC. Congratulations and break a leg.
Art recently headed to state last weekend. Congratulations to Aleida Ramirez and Jade Hernandez, who both came home with gold medals. Aleida also received an $800 scholarship that is only given to one student out of the entire state of Texas. Congratulations to you both.
Mark your calendars, the annual Powder Puff Game is back. On May 17th, junior and senior girls will be competing in a game of flag football with our boys as coaches and cheerleaders. Seniors will be wearing pink shirts, juniors will be in green, and sophomores will be in white. Tickets will be sold for $1. The storefront for the shirts closes May 5th, so be sure to purchase your grade level shirt to show your support. Shirts can be ordered through the Deer Time module. For sports, we turn to Megan Butler.
Thanks, Bella. A huge congratulations to Jacob M. for advancing to the state track meet. The meet will be tomorrow at the University of Texas in Austin. Good luck in discus, Jacob. Our baseball team started off the first round of playoffs last night against North Shore. They jumped out to a 2-0 lead in the first inning and never looked back, coasting to a 7-1 victory. They will play Game 2 tonight at North Shore beginning at 7 p.m. Game 3, if necessary, will be tomorrow at 2 p.m. at North Shore. Good luck, guys. Our Lady Deer softball team kicked off playoffs last week, sweeping the North Shore Mustangs in two games. They kicked off the second round last night against Alvin in a one-game winner-takes-all matchup. Unfortunately, our girls came short, 5-0, bringing their season to an end. Earlier this week, 38 of our students committed to perform at the collegiate level of annual signing day. Good luck in this next chapter of your life. Hopefully no unexpected transfer portal athletes take your spot. Emily Ripley and Audrina Silva took a closer look into what the portal is and how it affects student athletes. Take a look.
Recently, the NCAA transfer portal has gained a lot of attention due to the amount of athletes that enter and exit it. The NCAA transfer portal was created on October 18, 2018 to manage and facilitate student athletes who are looking to play their sport at another college. Players that choose to enter the transfer portal could be unhappy with their college, want to get more playing time, transfer to a more competitive school, or change in coaching staff. For example, Alabama's head football coach Nick Saban, after 17 seasons, announced his retirement with the Crimson Tide. This sparked many big-name Bama players like Isaiah Bonds, Caleb Downs, and Caden Proctor, along with 8 other teammates, to enter the transfer portal. While in the transfer portal, coaches from other schools can offer these athletes scholarships to play their sport at their school. This is a great chance for athletes to thrive with another team and succeed in their sport even more than they did in the past college. For example, starting point guard at the University of Houston, LJ Cryer originally committed to Baylor University and had a decent 3 years with the team. Even though Baylor came home with a national title, Cryer believed he still had more room for improvement and entered the transfer portal, where Houston decided to give him a chance. Cryer is now a starter for the 25-3 Cougars and averages 15 points per game. While this is good for college athletes, high school athletes are put in difficult circumstances. If a high schooler wants to play their sport in college, they now have to earn a spot against other high schoolers and people that have experience at the collegiate level. This slims down the opportunity for high school athletes to compete at the college level more than it already is. Overall, the transfer portal provides great opportunities for college athletes and creates competition for a spot on a team between high schoolers and college athletes.
Seniors, you have to get through graduation first before you can attempt to go to college. The only graduation practice will be held May 17th in the auxiliary gym at 7:30 in the morning. Every senior who wants to walk must attend, and you have to be in dress code. The seating information will be available in Canvas starting May 13th. If you miss the practice, you can attend the makeup day on Tuesday, May 21st in the PAC at 8:45 a.m.
But you still have a few more weeks left. AP testing will start next week and will continue through the 24th. If you have not started studying, I highly suggest that you say just a little prayer for yourself. While AP tests can't be exempt, the high school finals can. As you may know, finals are going to be coming up pretty soon, and I'm pretty sure you don't want to take any of your finals. If you want to be exempt from all your finals, you must be passing your class with an 80 or above, have no more than 3 days of absences per class, and seniors. Remember, in order to participate in the graduation ceremony, all fees must be cleared by today, May 3rd, before 4 p.m. Fees can be paid online through My School Bucks or right here in the AP's office. Remember that checks will not be accepted.
This week's College of the Week is Houston Christian University. The HCU Huskies offer a wide selection of over 100 undergraduate majors, pre-professional programs, and graduate-level degrees. They ultimately strive to send students out into the world with a better understanding on how to live a fulfilling, accomplished, and righteous life. The application deadline for the fall semester is August 1st.
And that's it for us this week. Be sure to check us out on Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, TikTok, and YouTube for more amazing content. For everyone here at the DIN Network, I'm Jace Dominguez.
And I'm Bella Smith, wishing you a great day and a wonderful weekend.
And go Deer!